Off of a daily heave. So think of it this way, okay? So I have a daily heave here. I'm gonna get, typically I teach you guys where your controlling is, not controlling, where your point of contact is at his kind of Achilles. And my objective is to kind of push him and to tilt him this way. This pant grip, we're gonna call the Leandro Low grip, okay? Because he used to grab the pants like this because it's hard for him to disconnect his foot from my hip. Start backing up a little bit. Yeah, it connects, okay? So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start with control of this sleeve right here. And the way I'm gonna get the X guard is like this. I'm gonna push him away with my right foot, my left one goes underneath, and I'm gonna scoot underneath here as my left foot goes to his left hip. My right foot goes on the inside of his knee, and I align myself underneath, okay? I have an overhook on his foot, all right? Which for me, I like because it makes more sense, okay? So what I'm gonna do is, I can have that sleeve of the collar. I need to be underneath him enough where I can begin to load his weight up on me and lift me so that I can get here, but don't fall. You're gonna have to fall. Okay. My objective is to potentially sweep him either to the right or left. If he's up, you see his hand is on the mat. I'm gonna grab this sleeve here, okay? And I'm gonna pull his sleeve here as I'm going to shift his weight here. And I'm gonna scoot in. Grab his back here. Here you can just mount forward to the side. All right, one more time. Try to get in the next one. Let's say I have this sleep the whole time. Get a heaver, get the Leandro Low grip, it's the pants, it's a little bit on the looser side, and it's a twist. So from here, I'm gonna push, zoom in, my knee is on the outside. My right, my left foot goes to his hip. Scoop here. This here I should be able to lift him up and tilt him this way here. From here, it shouldn't be a problem for me to be able to keep pushing him over his left shoulder and sitting up. And now right here. From here. Get this side control. Okay? Done. The key is to be able to get into X guard because they're going to be very squirmy up top. Okay? You have this grip. Why do I have this grip? Come down to the guard. Because as I feel him trying to stand, he stands. And I already have this grip right here. Okay? If he breaks this grip, postures up, I can go back to this grip right here. Okay. Push him away. He goes through here. He popped out. Push him away. And I kind of scoot underneath as my left foot goes to his hip right here. And my right foot is behind the knee. And my left hand is right here. So I'm kind of guillotining his right foot. From here, I should be able to load his weight up. But one thing he should not be able to do is back up away from me. Okay? Because my right foot is pulling that way. My left foot is pulling this way. And he's locked right here. If your toes are going to be pointed, he will get off that hook very easily and continue to pass. And that's another pump down. So your left foot goes to this hip here, and your right foot prevents him from stepping back. You don't want to be stagnant here. But what's going to happen is you're constantly going to have to adjust your hips and shift their weight. So as I pull him to the right, don't fall. This is what his hand's going to be committed to the mat. I switch here, yeah? And I'm going to start pulling here, sitting up here. screwed in. From here, I want to scoot in even more. And now I can unhook my legs and get into side control, whatever it may be. Does that make sense?
One more time.
Without the knee pop. So, if you have this hand controlling the sleeve, that's great. Get the Leandro a little grip. Push. And I keep scooting him away. So he falls. From here, my right hand's not doing me any good. Even though I could do this and then begin to pass from a different point. But from here, I wind up in an open guard. And I'd rather have less space in order to get him there tight. Second. What you're going to do is you're going to pull them in, and you're going to pull yourself under. So you want to be under them. You don't want to be kind of off your on your side. So if we're here, the Elahiva here, push away. If now I have control of him. Alright? From here, I want to have control of his foot because there's other options we'll go into. But as you see, he may try to want to stand up. Okay? But I have to keep this balancing him. And now readjust myself to get underneath him. So he stands up. Okay? See, it's like I need to adjust my hip. You see, I have to constantly keep adjusting my hip, and I can pull and trip him over himself. From here, I want to, and then when you get the control, it won't be as easy as it looks, but there's a scramble, and you want to be on top, put him on yourself, whatever. Right here. As you see, this foot will unhook. And I'm scooting in. And then go here. Because if he starts framing my head, my back, I'm going to. I'll do this right here. But the point is, it's sweet. What you do with it after is completely up to you. But for now, we'll start the Leandro low grip on the pants. Twist and lock it to your hip. So you have to start out with a dilly. Alright, let's do it. 1, 2, 3. 3. Justin.